in you all things were made, and nothing without you. In heaven and on earth, all things are held in you. And yet you became flesh, living as one of us, under the shadow of the cross, where through the blood you shed, you have made peace again.
There's a verse in the Old or in the Newer Testament that says that a friend of mine used to say that it's proof that women weren't allowed into heaven. It's in Revelation, swear in a stack of Bibles, because it says for a space of a half an hour there was silence in heaven. No? Okay, never mind. Well, welcome to the Huntsville United Methodist Church. I'm glad to see you all here today. I hope you're all doing well. You're all looking spiffy this morning. And we have a few things to take care of before we turn it over to Alice here. First of all, if any of you are visiting, we're really happy to have you here. Even if it's to see your grandkids, it's a great place to worship. If you want any answers, if you have any questions, we have some information on one of our tables in the back over here, or in the back in the hallway here. The flowers are on the altar are in memory of our loved ones that we've lost. So we also have prayer quilts over there. One is for Michelle Voorhees and Gilbert and Bob Oliver. If you don't know how that works, during the service, you can walk over there and tie a knot and say a prayer for the person that the quilt goes to. Also, next Sunday, correct? Yes, it is. Next Sunday after church, we're having a candy cane drop at Logan Acres. After the worship service, we'll all drive our cars over there and minister to the folks and families that are over there with candy canes and some candy bars. So if you would like to participate in that, please bring a box of candy canes or a bag of candy bars. Also, on December the 21st, there's a new service we're having here. It's called the Longest Night of the Year service. If you are just having some issues, or we're all having issues technically, but if you have, it's a difficult time of year for you, just come here to just pray, to worship God. If there's, there'll be people here that can pray with you if you'd like. You can stay for 5 minutes or an hour, whatever you'd like to do, and that is from 4 to 8 p.m. Pastor Brian, if you'd like to... One more thing, I should say. Yeah, sorry. No, I'm sorry, I was just exercising your back. I knew. You can come up here if you like. But on December the 24th, Christmas Eve falls on a Sunday this year, and we will be having two worship services, one in the morning, and then involving kids again. And then one again, of course, at 11 o'clock at night, and we'll end up worshiping into the Christmas day. So you're welcome to come to that. Amen to that, Hannah. Yay. Okay. It's in your hands.
Thank you, Mr. Eric. Good morning. Hey, I got just a couple things I want to address with you. First and foremost, I want to say thank you to Phil and Diane Tracy and to everyone who helped them decorate the church for Christmas. Doesn't it look beautiful? Give some love their way. I mean, this is always a great time of year. And what Phil and Diane were saying was they had all kinds of great help to get everything put up in place. And as you can see, that Christmas tree, it really helps to have tall guys and gals here. And they said it was just perfect. It went great. So if you helped, don't forget, here in about 6 weeks or so, in about a little over a month, we'll be taking this stuff down. So come on back and help out on that as well. Amen? All right. Hey, one of the other things I want to do is just draw our attention to our Angel Tree Ministry that we have here at the Huntsville United Methodist Church this time of year. We have really tried to invest ourselves wholeheartedly in this ministry. And I can give you a little background of what's going on. Here in Logan County, we know there are kids in family units that are under-resourced. Their families are under-resourced. It's just the kindest way to say it. And they are not going to have a Christmas. And so we work in conjunctions with Logan County Children's Services to get names of kids and their families whom we know are not going to have a Christmas. And our effort is to make sure they do. And not just to have a Christmas, but to have a great Christmas. And so as you see back there in the fellowship hall, we have our angel tree, and on them are the angels, and it has written down there a gift and who it's going for, at least the age and the gender, and it has a number to it. We just want to encourage you to go grab an angel, or two, or three, or four, whatever God lays upon your heart, and go out and you know, make that purchase, and then return that gift with the angel. Don't wrap it, because we're going to be giving those to the family they go to. But after you do that, when you come back, we have two boxes over there that you can just drop those gifts into. As you can see, they're in wrapping paper over there, looking like presents. I thought about taking credit for wrapping that nice, but you knew I would be lying. In any case, this is really, a meaningful activity at Christmas time. As I look around here, I think about how blessed and how fortunate all of us are. I mean, I look at how we dress, I look in the parking lot and I see our vehicles, I know where a lot of us live, and I know probably nobody in here struggled with a meal this morning or last night. We all had a warm bed, and you know, not everybody has that in their life. Not all those kids have the opportunity and the privilege and the blessings that you're going to see the kids up here on the stage that they have. But God has given us the opportunity to change that for certain kids in this county, in our community. So I just want to ask that you prayerfully consider going and grabbing some angels off that tree and making Christmas work for some kids in our community, in the Logan County community. And one final caveat to that, we handle between 40 and 50 kids for Children's Services. That's a lot of kids. That's a lot of kids. And I'm thankful that God has given this church and this body of Christ the opportunity to go be hands and feet in that way. If you would affirm that, would you respond with amen? Amen. Yes, and I was getting ready to turn to my wife to say, did I miss anything on the angel tree announcement? And she says, those gifts are due back next Sunday. So today, it'd be a great day. Go over to Anstein Hall, grab some of those angels, go get those gifts purchased, and then next Sunday, come on back, drop them off in the boxes over there, and you will know that you have made Christmas possible in a great way for some kids in Logan County. So, with that, we have entered the Advent season today, and to get us going in the right direction, I want to invite Rick and Shelley Chambers up to light our Advent candle and share in our Advent reading.
This is the first candle of Advent, the candle of the angels. It was the angels who delivered the good news of the birth of Messiah, first to Mary, his mother, then to Joseph, Mary's fiancé, and finally to the shepherds who were watching over the sheep. Today we light this first candle as a symbol of Christ, our hope. May the light sent from God shine in the darkness to show us the way of salvation. O come, Emmanuel. Amen.
All right, Alice, I think we're ready to turn it over to you.
Let's all stand on this very first Sunday of Advent, and let's sing with all of our hearts, "O Come All Ye Faithful." Let's stand as we sing.
Oh,
ushers come forward, would you please join me in prayer? Father, we thank you for this first day of Advent and when we celebrate the birth of your Son, Jesus Christ. I pray that we would live out this gift, Father, in our lives, and that these gifts that we offer to you, you would use to further your kingdom. We thank you for these things in Jesus' precious name. Amen.
Mara Reams, ladies and gentlemen, was that just not incredible?
Wow.
Don't go anywhere. You know, as she was playing, I remember when several years ago she did her kind of first piece on the piano here, and it was ding, 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 kind of. And it's funny because you were like that, and I'm just now noticing, like, we're about seeing eye to eye at this point. And that was beautiful. What was the name of that piece you just did?
Night Train.
Night Train. That was beautiful. And, you know, as you were playing that, I just thought to myself, between our opening set of music and then just hearing what she played on the piano, if you've been blessed by the music on this first Sunday of Advent, will you respond with amen?
Amen.
Amen. And give another round of thanks. Thank you, Mara. Just keep doing what you're doing. We might have ourselves a future worship leader for the Huntsville United Methodist Church. But who am I to think that far in advance, huh? So that was beautiful. We're going to get ready for a time of prayer here, but there's been a couple things come up, and I just want to share with you. First and foremost, I think I want to go here first. I don't see Catherine. Did Catherine go ahead and leave? Okay. Well, Catherine Miller, she came to church this morning and she just shared with me that her sister, Vaneva Merritt, is 103 years old. And her birthday is on Tuesday. It would make her 104. But I received a call from her son about 9:30, 9:40, saying Vaneva passed away today. And so I want to hold Catherine in our prayers along with her family. I mean, you know, she understood it. She had been going downhill rapidly over the last week and a half, but that doesn't make it any easier when it's your family and it's someone you love and you share life together. It just, the pain still stings. So I want us to keep her family in our prayers. And then I also have a note up here I do want to share, because this is important. This comes from the United Christian Services Food Pantry of Indian Lake. You know, we have two drop-off locations at each entrance. When you come in, you can drop food off and we take it up there. But they write to the Huntsville United Methodist Church, thank you so much for the delivery of 15 bags of donated items to the pantry. We calculated there was easily 150 pounds of food delivered last Thursday. It'll be a tremendous help in our December distribution. We served 249 families in November, and we expect that many for December too. So your support in this mission is appreciated. So for all of you who bring food in throughout the year, thank you so much, and God bless each and every one of you. It's making a difference in our region for people who are going hungry. Think about that today. We're going to feed people who are hungry. We're going to make Christmas possible for kids who wouldn't otherwise have it. You are doing the work of God in this community. So let's give some praise and glory to God at this time, would you? And then, finally, before I go on, many of you asked, hey, Pastor, how's your back doing? How's your back doing? Because yeah, I injured it a little bit, and I'm working on getting better. And I felt real strong last night. I felt a prompting come on. The Spirit was just saying, you know what? Just take a moment and testify, if you would. So I want to share with you just a quick passage, and I promise, because Alice said, hey, I want to get out of here early, so don't preach today. I said, all right. That's what she said, not to you. Are you kidding me? Don't tell me I shouldn't be preaching and making this church service run long. People love it when it runs long. Yes, they do, Hannah. So, hey, but in any case, I want to read with you a word from the book of Hebrews, chapter 11, verses 1 through 3. The writer says this, now faith is the assurance of things hoped for, the conviction of things not seen. Indeed, by faith our ancestors received approval, and by faith we understand that the worlds were prepared by the word of God, so that what is seen was made from things that are not visible. Now, why would I tell you that? Because I want to tell all of you that I believe my faith or my healing in my back has already occurred. It really has. I believe God has delivered healing to my body. And if you know me, you know that's part of my faith deal. I wholeheartedly support doctors. I've been to the doctors and medicine, the whole nine yards. But I believe faith has to go first. And according to the Word of God says your faith goes first. Faith is the evidence of things hoped for, the conviction of things not seen. I am believing that my healing has already occurred. Here's my caveat. My back just has to catch up to that healing. Does that make sense? So I am going to live and move forward as if the healing has already occurred. I may move a little bit slower. I may be cautious about how fast I want to turn. But God in his love and in his grace and in his mercy has already poured out healing. And I want to claim it, and I wanted to share that with each and every one of you, because I'm thinking, and this is kind of what came over me last night, there's probably some folks here who are maybe facing a medical issue of one kind or another, and you're a little frustrated. And I thought maybe there's some folks in the house who facing some relational issues, maybe with a spouse, maybe with kids, maybe with parents. Maybe there's some financial issues going on and you're thinking, man, I just need things to get better. Well, church, The first step in that is by living out this faith and believing in the name of Jesus Christ that healing in whatever way needs to be manifested is happening. It's just your opportunity to claim it. This is how faith works. You claim it. You believe it first, then you'll see it secondly. A lot of the world says, I need to see it in order to believe it, but not us, not the followers of Christ. What we say is, I'm going to believe it by faith first, and then it will be manifest, and I'll see it with my eyes. So I just wanted to share that little testimony and that word. Thanks be to God, because his healing is coming due in all of our lives. If you would affirm that, would you respond with amen? Okay. Thank you for those who filled out the prayer request this morning before church. I have them here, and I think we're ready for a time of prayer. So let's bow our heads. No, wait, time. Oh, you want the kids now because you got to organize them. This is Leadership 101. See, this is how the staff communicates. That's all right. Hey, kids, Ashley and company, they are asking for your presence back there. So head on back, all right? If it appeared that I missed my cues and marks, I'll apologize. Because I guess I did. All right. Well, I know, kids, I know that there's a lot of excited parents and grandparents and aunts and uncles and family friends out here ready to watch them do their thing. And if I'm looking at my clock, I know we can... I'll keep this moving so they can get in here. So, all right, now I think we're ready to have a word of prayer. Let's bow our heads, okay? Well, Almighty God, we just want to say thank you that today we have this time with you, with each other, and we start our journey into the season of Advent. And now together, God, over the next several weeks, we're going to sing songs that remind us of why you came to this earth and how you came to this earth. And we'll revisit the story that at times seems unbelievable, and yet it is true. And you know, God, really, that's the amazing thing about a life with you. It's a way of life that has the full-blown potential to change our lives in a way that we could never imagine. Hardened hearts can be softened. Hatred can be converted into love. Joy can fill our hearts and our minds that were once buried under condemnation and guilt and judgment. And ultimately, a belief and a commitment to you forgives us of our sins and gives us a pathway to eternal life. And all that, God, is what awaits us as we enter into this Advent season. So God, for this time, thanks be to you. And Lord, we just want to offer ourselves and offer this prayer to you now in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And today, God, we want to lift up the prayers of our people. And I want to pray for Catherine, God, and pray that you comfort her in this time. And speak to her in only the way that you can. And remind her of the gift of eternal life and the promise of heaven for those who go before us. And then, God, I think about all those kids who are here ready to come do their musical today. We pray for them, for each and every child, and we pray for everybody involved in it. And I pray that when they take this stage up here, God, your spirit just guides them and that they sing joy for you, and it fills the heart of this congregation, and it fills the lives of these people, and they smile, and this congregation is drawn closer to you in the name of Jesus Christ through the ministry of these kids. So I pray for them today. And then, God, we pray for Rose, Steve and Judy, Madison, for Lawrence, Bill, and Dorothy, as well as Norma, Helen, Travis, and Matt. We give to you Ethan, Levi, Bruce, and the Elvers. We pray for Randy, Mike, and Pam, Bonnie, and Anita, as well as the families of Coletta Schaff and Tom Schaff. We pray for Bob, Loretta, and the family of Rance Harp. And then, God, we give to you Anita and Rhonda, Chris and Rachel, Scott and Shannon, and Karen and Steve. We pray for Brittany, Dustin, and Midnight, for Bob and Dave. We offer up to you Rhett, Julie and her family, as well as John and his family. And we pray for Colby, Ben, Aaron, Donna, and Jean, as well as Dale, Steph, Shirley, and Jack. Today we present to you Larry and Joanne, Sharon, Tina, Tanner, and Tom, as well as Larry and Susan and her family. We pray for Ray, Tony, Justin, and Andy, as well as Mary, Katie, Matt and Peggy, Tom and Vicky, Sue Ann, Janet, Ted, Roger, and Don. And for all the other prayers that get brought to this time and place, God, we offer them up to your throne in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who taught us to pray all together and aloud in one common voice. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Amen indeed. And with that, friends, I do not see Alice, but I do know that we are getting ready for a Christmas musical. So, Miss Alice, are you ready? Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the Youth Christmas Musical. Would you welcome them here?
this morning to celebrate our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Would you please join me in prayer before we begin? Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day and opportunity to celebrate the greatest gift of all, your Son Jesus. Be with us as we celebrate, sing, and rejoice today. In Jesus' name, pray. Amen.
motion of monumental proportion. The sky lit up and we were blinded by the brightest light ever. We all fell to the ground in fear, thinking this must be the end of the world. Then suddenly, we realized it was angels, and my, what a message they had.
Bye. Jesus on the side of us comes to set us free. Doors are like
And so I thank you, kids, for what you've done. And then at this time, you can head on back to your parents or to your guardians where they're at in the pews. Well done. And while they're heading on back, friends, I'm going to take just a moment and I want to say thank you to Alice, who worked with them along with Ashley and Jenna and all the others back in junior church and on Monday nights when they were working on it. Would you join me in showing your appreciation for the adults? Well, I think as the band comes up here and gets ready, we'll just close out this time with a word of prayer. Would you just bow your heads with me? God, thank you so much for the gift of music today, for the gift of your kids, for the gift of these kids who just celebrate your great name. And Lord, thank you for this time of Advent when we anticipate the birth of Jesus and this Christmas season that's coming upon us. God, indeed, fill our hearts with joy, that as we move from this place, we would take that joy and share it with all those around us. God, we offer this prayer and ourselves to you now in the name of Jesus. We all agree and said, amen. Alice, I'm going to go over to you.
I just want to tell the kids, thank you so much for all that you do. Even some of those kids didn't want to be up there. I heard a second before we came out. So they did fantastic. I'm really proud of them. But kids and parents alike, right after worship is over, if you'll go back to the same room where you put your costumes on, someone will be there to help get your costume back from you, okay? Thank you so much. Now let's stand as we close out our service with O Little Town of Bethlehem. Let's stand as we sing.
Say thank you to Alice and the whole band. Great music set tomorrow, and to the kids. It has been a Sabbath of music, and we are the better for it. So friends, as the season of Advent falls upon us, remember it is ours to take this season of Advent and share it with the world around us, that the cross of Jesus Christ would be lifted up from the nativity there in Bethlehem. You are his messenger, so go forth now in the name of Jesus Christ and in God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Come to us,